Murray Bridge veterans fear anti-war campaigners have tried to sabotage Anzac Day by stealing an historic monument from the RSL. Police equally appalled by the theft, but less clear about a motive. Brett Clampett's filed this report from the stunned country community.
Murray Bridge's returned soldiers lost mates. Now they've lost faith. Nothing in their tight-knit community is sacred.
Mongrel, low act. No care for their country or the people that fought for their country.
Very low. They'd probably just about sneak under a snake's belly, I guess.
This fully restored World War I mortar sat proudly outside the RSL club for 60 years, donated by the family of a fallen soldier. It was to be bolted down today as the centrepiece of a memorial to be unveiled at tomorrow's Anzac Day service. Police suspect up to four thieves loaded the 400-kilogram monument into a car. The president fears anti-veteran sentiment is a motive.
You get people out there that, for some reason, raise their heads on Anzac Day and tend to blame the returned servicemen and veterans for their efforts.
The club is warning against vigilante action.
You can't get even, but revenge is sweet, but no, you can't get vicious.
But local police are equally as appalled.
We'll be hunting these people down. They need to be accountable for this action because it doesn't represent the Australian spirit.
It didn't take long for the rumour mill to fire up here in Murray Bridge. Police received a number of tip-offs from the public. It helped them compile a list of suspects capable of such an act.
We have a large database of information on people who do stupid things.
Scrap metal theft, also a possible motive, or a misguided collector. The $40,000 relic is insured.
The value is remembrance and history.
Brett Clappis, 10 News.